Right? Set it off, G, because we are setting it off right here on the table. Man, last Thursday we had nothing but all-star heat. Tonight we've got workout to SBs to... I mean, I'm going to let Kadoma tell you all about it, because he is here from the H-Town Sneaker Summit. And if you missed Sunday's show live from Orlando, it was an all-star affair.
Wait a minute.
He's here. Wow. He's here, oh. With all the parties, shooligan riots, all-star celebrities in the mix, and of course, all of our thoughts.
Did somebody say shooligan riot?
Yeah. I think there is a shooligan riot here tonight, because the man who I knew was going to be a guest on the show tonight, not only is he on the show, but he is here live and in person, Kadoma. And why don't you give him the proper introduction, because you can find him on Fairfax, but tonight you can find him right here at Junction Bar and Grill.
That's right. We got my man Bobby all the way here from Los Angeles, Flight Club Los Angeles.
Exclusive.
Right here at Junction Bar, right here in the Sport Trap Lounge.
Rap Pack, put your hands together for Bobby.
For those of you that don't know what Flight Club is, it's probably the world's largest sneaker consignment shop. So it's where you take those treasured finds that don't fit anymore or never did, or you just never got around to wearing, or you purchased intentionally to resell. You take them there to sell them. So Bobby's here. And he's going to tell us a little bit more about Flight Club, where we can find it online and physically. And so why don't you say what's up to everybody out there in the Sport Trap Lounge and iHeartRadio world, Bobby.
Oh, let's get that mic turned on. Hit that switch.
I have to flip that switch. There you go. All right,
try this one more time. So what's up, everybody? It's good to be back home.
So where can we find Flight Club online or physically?
Well, you can find us at flightclub.com, and then you can also find us at 503 North Fairfax, right in the heart of everything.
Wow. Everything.
He
just gave you that blanket statement. That's right in the heart of everything. Of course, 451 North Fairfax, our good friends right down the street at Diamond Supply Co.
Shout out to Nick Diamond.
Of course, and Tony Tones and the whole Fairfax native posse.
The whole Rosewood family.
Well, you know, we just got back from All-Star Weekend out there in Orlando. They shut down the release due to a shooligan riot. I think Ganj just cued the shooligan siren a little bit earlier for us. But did you see any pairs of Galaxy Foams here lately?
Here or?
At Flight Club.
Oh, yeah. I think we've got five pair by now.
And what are those running for over at Flight Club right now?
I don't even want to say.
We need you to tell our studio audience that's unfamiliar with shooligan culture.
Right now is going for about $2,300.
That's what I said. Woo! Average price. It's a payday loan to get your shoes.
Yeah. Oh,
and wow. What was the box price on those?
Box price was what? One.
It was two flat.
Two flat.
$200.
Yeah, I would say it just depends on how much tax was or whatnot.
I think it was $220.
Okay, $220. Yes. $220 in the building tonight.
It basically went up in price times 10.
Yeah, absolutely ridiculous. $2,300 for a pair of foams. I mean,
well, Bobby, look, Jordans, you know, each and every week for 134 weeks, we bring the great people here of Sports Rap Live and the Rap Pack our Sneak of the Week. Yeah. Last week, it was our Sneak of the Week number 133. And Kadoma and I got on a plane the very next day to land in Orlando and find out that they had shut down the release. And there was even a sign when you walked in the Florida Mall there in Orlando that said, no all-star sneaker releases for the weekend.
That's insane, dude. Like, to be honest with you, I mean, from where the city that I'm at right now, I mean, the way sneakers are, it's pretty ridiculous. But everybody was acting calmly. You know what I'm saying? Like, at the vault, there was, like, maybe 1,000-plus people. You know what I'm saying? And the vault is a really small, like, little closet, like, you know, exclusive boutique. But for 1,000 people to be in that area was, I mean, insane. But, I mean, everybody acted accordingly, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of people dealt with it, you know, cool. So
grown folks' business.
Yeah, basically. Yeah.
Well, let me ask you this, Bobby. What is the craziest thing that you've ever seen at Flight Club? Like, give us your Flight Club moment.
Wow.
I know the Galaxy Foam has to be one of them, but I'm pretty sure you've seen some crazy stuff come through.
Yeah, to see the people line up at our store for that shoe, I mean, it was just, you know, kind of ridiculous, you know, knowing that we don't do releases on, you know, drop dates and whatnot. So, you know, but it sounds kind of corny, but my favorite shoe that I've seen come through was the Admiral, the David Robinson.
Wow. Oh, okay. Wow, they haven't retroed those in a minute or ever.
Yeah, yeah. No, I don't think they ever have. And the dude actually had, you know, the big clear box that it comes in.
Yep, I remember those.
A good moment in my life when I saw it. I haven't seen those since I was a kid. I think it was like fifth grade when they came out.
I believe those are called the Air Commander, I want to say. What did those go for? What was that asking price?
Honestly, I didn't take the shoe simply because it was already too dry rotted. Like, it was already falling apart, and I didn't want that liability, you know what I'm saying? If somebody's, you know, grail sitting on the shelf just, you know, falling apart. So, I kind of passed on it, but it was awesome to see, you know?
It's an even better part of the story because it was something that you were just excited to see, you were throwing on the shelf, you know?
Yeah.
That's awesome,
And
man.
For those that don't remember, the Air Commander was kind of Nike's answer to the Reebok Pump. All of the attention that Reebok was getting with the popular pump shoes. And speaking of Reebok, we have some Reeboks on the table tonight as Gons plays the New Orleans Beats.
Yes.
You know, this is a very popular shoe in New Orleans. We just celebrated the 25th anniversary of the Reebok Workout Plus. So these actually released last month, February 15th. We were in the thick of things going to Magic and All-Star there in Orlando. In between Vegas, and we happened to miss out on this release, but our executive producer Bun B was sent an entire box of these shoes, so I wanted to get them on the show for an honorable mention tonight.
Or a sneak peek, you know, just give people a little peek.
Well, it's hard to be a sneak peek when it's already out in stores, so you can go cop these right now. But what they did for the 25th anniversary of this classic Reebok silhouette is they actually got some of their select accounts to design shoes. So you see shoes here from the end of the table, from Sneakers and Stuff, Foot Patrol, Atmos, which are all overseas boutiques, namely Japan, UK, Sneakers and Stuff, I believe, I want to say Australia, but I'm not entirely sure. I'm not even sure how to say this one. Amida, 24 Kalatis. So I believe there's about a dozen or so pairs in the pack that you can find everywhere. So this is what I like to have for Sneak of the Week, something for everyone. You're going to find a pair of these you like unless you're just not a fan of this silhouette.
Doma, over the years, we've seen a lot. Our friends up there at Packer on the East Coast have sent us some of their kicks. Did they collab with Packer?
Yeah, they have a Packer shoe. We unfortunately do not have that one here tonight in the SRL lounge.
Right.
But I'm sure you can call up there to Packer Shoes and grab you a pair of those.
Awesome, awesome. All right, well, as we continue to move towards our Sneak of the Week, number 134, Kadoma, let's shift from Reebok to Nike, which is always a fan favorite here on Sports Rap Live. I'm a Nike head for life. We all know that. But why don't you tell us a little bit about the SBs we have here on the table?
Well, shout out to Tanner and Co. for bringing out the March SBs, some of the March SBs. Nike skateboarding has been very popular here for almost the past decade. And what we have here tonight is some of their more casual shoes, the Nike Dunk. Some of you will remember that as a basketball shoe, which was kind of transformed into a skate shoe, a little more cushioning, a little more comfort, with the Zoom Air bag in the heel. And now they have a soft Phylon midsole. Is that how you say that, Bobby?
Yeah.
So, you know, this is the high is actually the black and tan dunk. Some people are calling it the Guiness dunk.
Actually, but it reminds me, not to interrupt, but it kind of reminds me of the Tekashi.
Tekashi.
Absolutely.
A very popular Nike SB colorway. But they do have a quick strike this month called the Guiness Dunk Low, or the Black and Tan Dunk Low. Nike SB has had a lot of adult beverage-themed shoes.
Sure.
From Heineken to Dos Equis to
Newcastle.
It goes on and on. So Guiness, what was that one?
The Jaeger.
Jaeger.
Yeah.
I believe we had that one on the
sure
show.
But Jaeger.
But now Newcastle is getting its run on the brand. Guiness.
And Bass. We got to shout out Bass because the black and tan is Guiness and Bass traditionally.
But shout out to Guiness for finally getting a shoe. And I hear it's a quick strike for St. Patrick's Day release.
Makes sense.
So there's a good chance we could feature that Guiness Dunk Low quick strike here on the Sneak of the Week in a couple of weeks unless something else happens to drop and knock it out the way. Yeezy. But that's what I'm hearing right now. Next up, we have the SeaCrystal Dunk Mid, which is the same shoe, but a mid-cut. It used to feature a strap. Right now, it does not feature the strap. We hear the ankle strap is coming back. Although this is called the SeaCrystal colorway, it reminds me more of the Tiffany's, sure, which our good friend Nick Diamond at Diamond Supply Co. designed at Nike SB's Peak. Way back near 2005.
I would say
at first glance, I thought it was a sample.
Yeah, and then seeing it here on the table, if you guys are listening on Sports Talk 790 and you can't see it, you can go to our podcast powered by amphouston.net to see the sneakers and sneakertube.tv to see our Sneak of the Week segment, of course, every week with Kadoma. But this is a little bit on the turquoise side. Tiffany's a little softer, a little lighter. But, yes, of course, this can be rocked with a lot of Diamond Supply Co. gear.
Well, I do remember a year or so ago, Nick did fly out to Beaverton to talk with the good folks at Nike SB, and I believe he designed some new colorways inspired by his diamond color scheme. This may be one of them. We may have to ask him about that. And we also recently saw a Costin 1 that looked very familiar as well.
Well, and the P-Rod. There was a P-Rod. I got P-Rods on tonight. Of course, first time I've rocked these, the forest green. But they did a diamond colorway with P-Rod. And we all know that P-Rod is on the diamond team with his hardware.
Well, also, you remember, a couple months ago, there was rumored that there was going to be a Tiffany a high.
Yes.
And there was a sample supposedly floating around somewhere, but it was supposedly with the ice bottom, and it was basically just a Tiffany high.
High with the ice bottom.
Yeah.
And that croc. Oh, my God. That would be
ridiculous.
Wow.
We might have to get those on the table. That is what you call That is what you call a grail, people, in the sneaker world.
Yes, it is. For people that slept on the lows, you need to make sure you pick up the highs. All right, Kadoma. Well, before we get into the bottom of the hour, right on time, let's get into the H-Town Sneaker Summit Sports Rap Live Sneak of the Week number 134. Do you understand? For 134 weeks, we have had a different Sneak of the Week, and we've got it on the table tonight, and I'm going to hand it down to you, Doma, so you can tell us all about it.
Man, this is the Stefan Janowski Jersey Fleece, or Metallic Silver. This is the Nike SB Stefan Janowski, his signature shoe, a professional skateboarder for Habitat Skateboards, actually winner of Skater of the Year a time or two. And
or Janos, as they call them.
But this is a very casual silhouette. It's probably Nike SB's half cab or Vans half cab. It's the one designed for skateboarding by skateboarders, whereas the Dunks here on the table is a basketball shoe or a traditional Nike shoe that was transformed to meet the needs of skateboarding. This one was designed by a skateboarder for skateboarding, but it still has a very casual boat shoe look to it.
Oh yeah.
And they kind of hit a home run with this silhouette because even though it's very, very simple, just a little change of the colorway, different materials, it brings an entirely new look to the shoe. And this is the first time it's actually featured a jersey fleece material or a sweatpant type material, which may not be all that good for skateboarding, but it sure is comfortable. I have a feeling some Grizzly Grip would rip these right up.
Yeah, definitely.
You think so?
Touching base on the different materials and whatnot, my favorite one has to be the Michael Lau. The wood grain one?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, yeah, it's a little preference for wood grain, but, you know.
Bobby from Flight Club would consistently bring up the grails here at the
yes,
table.
Yes, yes. Well, let me ask you this. Do you see a lot of these Janos come through the doors there at Flight Club?
Yeah. I mean, especially with the Janowskis, like, I mean, it's for everybody. You know what I'm saying? It's taking the place of a dunk. You know what I mean? So everybody wears it. So yeah, when it comes to different materials and everything else, I mean, it's that's why, like you said, everybody buys it.
Yep, because we know you guys go heavy on the dunks. You guys go heavy on the SBs. But I'm just wondering, like, if a lot of kids are trying to sell their Janowskis, you know?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, and they're not really high priced. I mean, it's kind of average price. So, I mean, still a lot of people can afford it. Especially, like, the red one was, like, the most high most sought after one, that red, of course, you know, the Tiffany one.
Yep.
One, and then also like the black perforated. And I think they just recently did a Velcro.
They did.
They
did.
Well, I want to thank Bobby for stopping by from flightclub.com.
Yes.
The world's largest sneaker consignment shop that you can find out in LA, New York, and Tokyo, I believe.
Not anymore. Just LA,
okay,
New
just
York.
Online.
The recession's moving to Tokyo.
Hey, man. But I want to thank him for stopping by, and we will be out there in LA very soon for the last leg of the Gumball 3000 with our executive producer, Bun B Trillo G.
Yes, sir.
And probably back again sometime for Agenda Trade Show. So we're looking forward to coming by the shop and checking out what's in store at flightclub.com.
Hats off to Bobby. You know, when I heard you were joining the show, I thought you were calling in tonight from the shop, and I see you walk up. So, very good look, man. Glad you joined us here tonight.
Please, everybody, come check us out on Fairfax.
All right, well, we talked a little bit about the Jaeger dunks. We talked a little bit about the Newcastle, you know, the Dos Equis, you know, all dunks we cannot actually name technically, but we can here on Sports Rap Live. But if you are sipping on any of those beverages to match your sneakers, I want you guys to plug in the cowboy lawyer himself, Gary Trichter's number into your phone, because he is H-Town's top DWI lawyer. And I told you earlier, I gave you some tips. If you're going to drink like a lot of our friends here at the Rap Pack tonight, have a non-drinking designated driver lined up. Or if you're balling like half the kids here in the lounge tonight, take a cab or a limo to the house. Or, as Gon suggested, just sleep in the RV here at Junction Bar and Grill.
That's your own drunk tank.
That's
right over there.
That's right. That's right. Don't end up in the real one.
And there's not metal bars around.
No. You know? Well, there is one pole. It's not really a bar. It's a pole.
Yeah, but you're not, you know, in there.
No, it's not great.
You know,
for sure.
You're not in there forcefully.
No, but you know what? Both cost a lot less than having to actually call Gary Trichter. So if you do decide to drink and then drive, do not have any open containers in your car. Of course, you guys all know that. I don't have to tell you that.
Yes,
but follow the traffic laws religiously and do not give an officer a reason to stop you. If you feel like you got to swang and bang down Montrose or swang and bang through downtown, it just ain't worth it, man, because if you do get stopped, they're going to ask you questions, and you do not answer any questions about drinking because the officer is not going to believe you anyhow. You know that. The officer is going to take one look at you and say, get out of the car, and it's time to start doing curbside gymnastics and your alphabet backwards, which I can't even do sober. So I don't understand how you expect to get through after you've had a couple drinks. But be polite and ask for your lawyer, which is Gary Trichter, before doing any tests or answering any questions. And you know what? Remember that you're going to likely be on video. And what happens on video stays in video, and it's going to be recorded. And if you didn't know, a DWI could cost you 1 year suspension of your driver's license, 6 months in jail, a $2,000 fine, and a $3,000 minimum surcharge for a tax on your license. And that's going to double or triple your insurance costs. So all around, just save yourself the trouble. Plug my man's number into your phone. It's 713-524-1010. Once again, that's 713-524-1010. And visit TexasDWILaw.com if you want to see more of what I just told you about right here on Sports Rap Live.
I'm going to put that number in my phone right now under favorites. You know, speed dial, cowboy lawyer.
Well, hey, you know who else you want to have on speed dial? Girls. And the Dynamo Girls are here to tell you about the open auditions they have for all the talented ladies.
And we're getting them here. They were gaming it up over there.
Man, of course.
We're doing it big over there.
Shout out to the Space City Nerd. He's got the Dynamo Girls on the couch here in the Sports Rap Lounge.
I think they were trying to check out if they were inside FIFA FIFA on the console there.
Well, ladies, welcome to the table. Of course, I was just mentioning if any beautiful ladies out there who think they can dance, want to dance their way into the brand new BBVA Compass Bank Stadium.
Dance, 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 uh-huh. dance, dance.
Right? Hey, now make it hammer time.
Yeah, exactly. Well, make it dynamo time.
I tell you what, girls, how are you tonight? I'm so excited to have you here. First and foremost, we're excited about this new stadium. And why don't you introduce yourselves to the Rapp Pack here at Junction and all the listeners on Sports Talk 790.
My name is Carolyn, and this is my second year on the team, hopefully my third.
And my name is Linda, and this is also my second year on the team, hopefully my third.
Wait a second. Did you say hopefully?
We also have to try out just like all the other hopefuls.
What?
We are not guaranteed a spot on the
say
team
what?
Every year.
Hang on now. Who do we have to call? You guys are out here working.
Yeah.
Representing
working
the Dynamo.
Hustling.
Before you even go try out.
Yes. All the girls are out at practice right now, and we're here.
Well, of course you're here. Sports Rap Live is here. We are at Junction Bar and Grill. Put your hands together for the Dynamo girls, ladies and gentlemen. All right, so we know that you've both been with the Dynamo for 2 years. I'm going to ask you each, are you a soccer fan? We saw you playing FIFA on the Xbox here, but are you an actual soccer fan? Is that what sparked your interest to go try out for the dance squad?
I definitely am a soccer fan. I played soccer for 10 years growing up, so putting dance together with soccer was really easy for me when choosing to try out for Dynamo.
Same here. I used to play when I was in sixth grade, so I kind of have a little bit of background in soccer, and it was really good to see the soccer players playing out in the field, and it was something.
Oh, I'm sure it was.
Yeah.
I'm sure it was. You're in sixth grade, you see boys running around playing soccer. I'm sure it was good for you. But now it's good for all the fans of the Dynamo to see you on the sidelines dancing for their hometown team. Well, what do you guys think about the MLS? Do you think this is a league that is continually growing? You've been inside the, basically, you know, been on the sideline like I just mentioned. Is this a league that's continually growing with David Beckham winning the championship and the Dynamo being in the finals once again? Give us your thoughts on soccer as a whole in America.
I think as a whole, the past 2 years I've really been involved with the MLS, I can see its growth daily, game by game. More fans are coming out. We're getting our own stadium. We're the first downtown-focused stadium in all of MLS.
Oh, wow.
It's very earth-friendly. I mean, MLS is growing, and I think y'all are going to be surprised the transition it's going to take from American football to the soccer.
Wow. That's a bold prediction there.
Yeah. I'll stick with it.
All right.
Watch.
Downtown parking is going to be crazy.
It's going to be insane.
Crazy.
I'm excited. It'll be worth it.
Well, of course, ladies, before I get into a little more soccer talk with you, the new stadium is right behind Warehouse Live, and we have a special show tonight at Warehouse Live that we are going to give one ticket. There's only one ticket left in this city for this show tonight, and it is 2 Chainz. I ride around and I get it. Of course, the man himself.
Hey, you better ride around and get this ticket before it disappears.
I got one ticket right now. I'm either going to give it away to the first caller who's on their way down there and is looking for a ticket at 713-212-5790.
I heard it's a sold-out show.
It is sold out. This is the last ticket in the city right here. And that brand new stadium.
Ten.
Are you guys into 2 Chainz? You riding around, you getting it?
I know that song.
I know you do.
I heard it on the XM.
I know you do. You listen to Shade 45?
Yeah.
Shout out to the homie Rude Jude. Love that kid, man. He holds down Sports Shop Live every Thursday. All right, so call up if you want the ticket now. If not, we're going to give it away to a special member of the Rapp Pack. But ladies, you're here tonight because not only do you have to go back and audition, which I think is whack, and I'm going to talk to some people over there. I wish Oliver Luck was still over there. I'd give him a call, you know. I'd say, hey, Oliver, what's up, man? These ladies, they should be on the squad already. But why don't you tell us about the open auditions and when that's happening and where that's happening for the ladies out there that listen to Sports Rap Live.
Okay, well, if you're interested in trying out this year, tryouts are going to happen next weekend on March 10th. They are going to be happening at the Lifetime Athletic at City Center at 815 Town and Country Lane. For all the information for tryouts, you can go to houstondynamo.com/dynamogirls or call 713-276-7513. There are a couple requirements to be a Dynamo girl. You have to be 18 years or older.
You have to be hot. Is that on the list?
Don't start.
You have to take pride in your appearance. You have to be a high school graduate or have a GED. You must be a student or hold a full-time job.
When you come to auditions, bring your license, a headshot, a full-length photo, as well as wearing hot shorts, crop top, something that shows your belly, and flesh-colored tights.
Flesh-colored tights.
Yeah.
I'd like to see this.
Well, it's happening on March 11th at the...
March 10th.
I'm sorry. I had March 10th. I'm sorry, March 11th.
Is this a spectator event?
Saturday,
or
March
spectators
10th.
Allowed?
Oh, I thought you were going to go try out.
No.
Oh, okay.
No. I don't take pride in my appearance. Are you kidding me?
What? You got some skills, brother.
But he also doesn't have a pair of flesh-colored tights, man.
I forgot about that.
Damn. Well, ladies, now, what do you do throughout the off-season for the Dynamo? Of course, you're out here with your swag, and you got your Dynamo jerseys on. But what other events do you do as we head to break? Tell us a little bit about what it means to be a Dynamo girl.
Okay, well, throughout the year, we have to also fill appearances, and we have practice throughout the week before game days. We practice about 3 to 4 times a week, and we practice usually in the morning for tryouts. Practice.
Yes,
yeah.
Of course. Practice makes perfect.
Yes, yes. And, of course, appearances. And what it means to be a Dynamo girl is very exciting, having to meet new people and having to have this experience of dancing for a professional dance team. It's great. And I encourage girls to come try out.
All right, my last question comes from the soccer talker himself, Soccer Talk Luis, who covers the Dynamo for us right here on Sports Drop Live.
Religiously.
Uh-oh. Now, the last question is, who is your favorite Dynamo player?
My
Make it
favorite
quick.
Dynamo player is Brad Davis.
Brad
because
Davis?
Of his work with all the military base and his organization.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Off the field stuff. Awesome, awesome. And yourself?
Mine would be Jeff Cameron.
Jeff Cameron. Okay, all
just
right.
Just got back from Italy. He was playing with the U.S. Men's National Team last night.
Damn. Well, I don't know what other squad of a professional team has their own cards, but
no.
The ladies have their own cards. If you want to get one signed, make sure you ask them. They'll be here till 10 o'clock. Of course, thank you, ladies, for joining
thank
us.
Thank you so much for having
we
us.
We took it to overtime so we could have you guys on. So you guys stick around. It's time for the bad rap when we get back. I'm still looking for Dope Easy. I wonder if Dope Easy's in the house. He was supposed to come by and sprinkle some blue magic here. But if not, you know what? That's all right. We'll get him on in the near future. But you guys stick around right here on Sports Rap Live.